डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज टेक्नो साइंटिफिक मोटिवेटर डॉक्टर एस डी पुरी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ऑन दिस चैनल यू कैन सी द डिफरेंट वीडियोज रिलेटेड विद द मोटिवेशनल नॉलेज इंक्लूडिंग द साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी स्पेशल रेफरेंस टू द सब्जेक्ट जुआलॉजी। सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर संतोष डी पुरी, आई एम अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर। सो in this video we have to understand about the that is syllabus and exam pattern with the study plan for the year 2020-2021, specially for the BSc first year students. So all students those taken the admissions in the BSc first year, so they are most welcome in the college. So it is the your first year in the senior college, and so you must know about your subject, what type of syllabus is there, what type of exam pattern is there, and how you can plan your study plan for the this year. So in this video we have to understand here what is the pattern of the BSc first year and what type of syllabus is there. So first of all I want to tell you, so BSc first year having the two semesters, that is the first semester and the second semester. So this semester pattern is applicable from academic year 2013-14 onwards till today. So as per Nagpur University, the exam pattern and the syllabus for the subject zoology, especially for BSc first year, for the year 2020-21, so about all these we can understood by the help of this video. So dear students, as you know, myself Dr. Santosh D. Puri, I am assistant professor in Shankar Lal Agrawal Science College, Salekasa, district Gondia, and our college is affiliated to Rashtra Sant Tukdoji Maharaj Nagpur University, Nagpur. So we can start our video now. First of all, you must know the what type of syllabus or structure of the syllabus of subject zoology for the BSc first year first semester. As already I told that there are the two semesters. As you know, in the 11th standard you have given the exam of the first semester and the second semester. In the same way, there are the two semesters in the BSc first year. So first of all, you have to understand here what type of syllabus, which papers are there, and what type of the marking scheme for the first semester in the year BSc first year subject zoology. So you have to remember here there are the two papers in the first semester of zoology, that is the paper 1 and paper 2. The paper 1, the name is Life and Diversity of Animals, that is the non-chordate animals including the phylum Protozoa to the Annelida. So out of total 10 phyla, some phyla you have to study in the first paper in the first semester, and that paper having the or carry the 50 marks in the theory exam. In the same way, paper second, that is the environmental biology, and that paper also carry the 50 marks for the theory exam. So in this way there are the two papers and each paper carry 50 marks. Then you will get the some marks from the internal assessment, and these marks 10 marks for each paper. First paper carry 10 mark and first paper second paper carry 10 marks. So in this way 100 marks for the theory and 20 marks for the internal assessment. So total that is the 120 marks. Then also you have to conduct the some practicals on the paper 1, on the basis of paper 1 and paper 2, and combinedly that practical carry the 30 marks. So in this way 120 plus 30 equal to 150 marks. So in each semester the subject zoology carry the 150 total marks. So also you must know what are the passing criteria for the BSc first year or first semester. So as 120 marks of the theory exam, including theory and intern assessment, so out of 120 you must score the 40% marks, that is the 48 marks out of 120. And from the practical you must score the 40% mark, that is the 12 marks. So in this way there is a separate passing for the theory paper and the practical exam. So separately you must score the minimum 40% mark for the passing criteria, means total 48 plus 12, that is the 60 marks out of 150. Now in the same way, in the second semester also you having the same pattern, only the name of paper and syllabus is changed here, the paper third and paper fourth. Third paper again including the remaining phyla of non-chordates from phylum Arthropoda to the Hemichordata, and fourth paper, that is the cell biology. Exam pattern is the same, again you must score the 40% mark in the theory paper and separately in the practical exam. So this is the marking scheme for the BSc first year, that is the semester first and the semester second. Now as I told that you can get the total 20 marks of the internal assessment for the paper 1 and paper 2 in the each semester. So how can you can get these marks? So for that, that is on the basis of your attendance. Your attendance in the college must be greater than or more than the 75%. You must present in the college, but now there is a problem of the COVID, so you can attend the classes online and that will be your attendance. Then there are the different tests can be carried out by your professors in the colleges online or in the offline mode, and then you have to appear in these tests, and on the performance during that unit test exams throughout the year also there is a assessment for the marking through the heading internal assessment. Then you will get the some field work or assignments related with the topic of the syllabus. For example, you are the student of BSc first year first semester, you are studying the environmental biology, then you can get the topic for the field work, that is the like study of pond ecosystem. So you can visit to the any pond ecosystem or lake ecosystem in your area, and you can observe the components of the ecosystem, and you can make the one report on that field work or assignment. You can complete it, make the report, and that you have to submit to your professor, then you can get the 20 mark. So in this way this is the marking scheme. Then we have to understand the what type of syllabus is there. So for the first semester, the first paper, the name, that is the non-chordata from phylum Protozoa to Annelida. You can see the that is the phylum Protozoa, then examples from the Protozoa, Paramecium, Plasmodium or parasites. So all these you can study under the phylum Protozoa. This is the unit 1. You have to remember that the every paper consists of the 4 units, and now these in the first unit you can study about the phylum Protozoa. In the second unit you can study about the Porifera, Coelenterata. So all these are the phylum, or we can say that phyla, that is the plural word of the phylum. Then third unit of the helminths, that is the Platyhelminthes, Aschelminthes, so these are the another phyla. Then fourth unit consists of the phylum Annelida. So from Protozoa to Annelida you can study about these syllabus of zoology in the paper first for the first semester. Then second paper for the first semester is the environmental biology. Same pattern is there, there are the 4 units and having the different topics: atmosphere, ecosystems, biodiversity, then pollution. So these four units you can study under the second paper, that is a environmental biology. So these two papers for the first semester. Then also, what type of practicals and what is the pattern of practical exam for the first semester, also you can understand from this point. So see here, that is the on the basis of paper 1 and paper 2, there is a practical. You can observe the some museum specimens in the laboratory or some slides, and then you can write the characteristics, draw the diagrams, and you can complete your practicals in the laboratories. Then secondly, that is a study of permanent slide. Some slides may be available in your laboratory, and these slides you can observe under the microscope, note down their features, and you can do the study of the permanent slides. Then dissection, that is the dissection of earthworm, you can do in the laboratory. Digestive system, nervous system, and reproductive system of earthworm. You can do these dissections if earthworms are available in the laboratory. Otherwise, you can watch the videos of these particular systems of the earthworm, and you can understand how the dissection can be done. Then mounting means you can prepare the some slides some material you can provide it in the laboratory, and then you can prepare the slides, and that is the mounting, and these slides you can submit towards your professor. Then on the second paper, environmental biology, there are the some experiments like estimation of dissolved oxygen of water. So all these environmental experiments you can complete in the laboratory or in the field work. Then there is a one visit, it's compulsory. You can visit to any national park or sanctuary or pond, lake, what may be the nearby that visiting place near to your college. Then you can visit to that particular place and make a report, and then also there are some marks on that particular visits. Then distribution of marks of practicals. Total marks of that is a 30 marks for the practical. So what type of distribution is there? That is the identification and comment on the spots, means what may be the specimens or slides you have observed. So 8 marks for the spotting. Out of these 4 museum specimens you can study there, 1 environmental spot and 3 permanent slides. Then dissection, for the dissection there are the 8 marks. Then you can complete the 1 environmental biological experiment, for that 4 marks. Then permanent stain preparation slides, 3 marks. Submission of the certified practical record. So what may be the you have studied or what may be the practicals you have done. So you have to write in the practical journal book, and you certify from your professors and head of the department and submit it, then you can get the 3 marks. Submission of slides and tour diary, mounting slides and tour visit. So that report you have to submit, then you can get the 2 marks. And for the Viva, there are the 2 marks. When your examination will be conducted by the university, then external can ask the some questions related to the topic on the practicals. So for that, you can get the 2 mark. So in this way, total mark, that is the 30. So this is the pattern of the practical examination. Then in the same way for the second semester, only there is a change in the name of the paper. Now this paper, Naonocordata, from phylum Arthropoda to Hemichordata. Same pattern, 4 units, different phyla you can study in this paper. In the same way, second paper means, that is the for the second semester, we can say that paper number 3 and paper number 4. So cell biology is the 4th paper for the second semester. Then you can study about the cytology and the genetics in that particular paper. Again, the practical pattern is also same, only there is a changing in the topics. Again, there is a study of museum specimen, permanent slides, dissection of cockroach, phyla, mounting, then some experiments related to the cell biology, and again same distribution of the marks, that is a 30 mark. So in this way, you can understand about the syllabus of the zoology. Then what type of question paper pattern? So that we have to understand here. Now, as per the current rules and regulations of the Nagpur University, the paper of the theory exam having the 50 marks and the pattern is, you can see here. So this is the one of the paper for the BSc first year first semester subject zoology, and this paper on the non-coded paper, that is the paper 1. So you have to remember that this pattern is as per the current rules and regulations, but due to the COVID there may be chance of the changing when your exam will be there. But as per the notifications and what may be the directions, rules, regulations of the current situation, so this is the exam pattern of the Nagpur University. So in this paper all questions are compulsory. Every question carry equal mark, that is a 10 marks for each question. Total 5 questions are there. Where there is a need of the diagrams, you have to draw the diagrams. For example, what type of pattern is there? Question number 1st to 4, all these questions are having the similar pattern, that is the there is a one long question of the 10 for the 10 marks. For example, describe the life cycle of Plasmodium, for that you can get the 10 marks. Or you can solve the two short questions, that is a classification of phylum Protozoa or and Entamoeba. So you can write the short notes, and these questions carry the 5 mark each. Means you can solve one long question for the 10 mark, or you can solve the two short questions for 5 mark. So this same pattern for the question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 and question number 4. Means 4 descriptive questions for 10 marks or 5 marks questions in the or options. Now the question number 5 is different. The question number 5 having the total 12 questions, and out of these you have to solve the any 10 questions, and you can write the answers of these questions in a very short, that is the in the 4 to 5 lines only, and then you can get the 1 mark for the each question. So in this way you can solve the any 10 questions out of 12 questions. So this is the question number 5. So in this way this is the pattern of the paper. Now this is the first paper. Then you can see the second paper also having the same pattern, that is the name only change, environmental biology, pattern is the same, no change is there. In the same way for the second semester also there are the two papers, that is this the paper first we can see that for the second semester. So also the same pattern is there, that is the total 5 questions, and in the second semester paper number 4, that is the cell biology, and that pattern is also same. So in this way you can solve the total 4 papers in the BSc first year. In the first semester exam there are the 2 papers, first and second paper. In the second semester exam also there are the 2 papers. Means throughout the year you have to solve the 4 question papers. So this is all about the question paper pattern. Then we can do the some plan for the study. So you can make your self study plan. I have given here one plan how you can prepare your self study plan, and these dates are the tentative, and this plan is for the BSc first year student for the first semester subject zoology. Now this first semester now started from September 2020 to December 2020. Means for the each semester there is a period of the near about 4 months. So within the 4 months we must study about the first semester, that is a September to December 2020. Now what type of plan you can do for your study? There are the 2 papers in the first semester having the 4 units in the first paper and 4 units in the second paper. So total 8 units are there, and you have to study these 2 papers of zoology for the first semester from September to December. There may be the chance of the exam in the December or January. So what you have to do during this period? First of all, you have to attend the all lectures by your professors in the online mode or offline mode. Then you can prepare your notes, you can do the reading, then you can draw the diagram, do the practice of drawing the diagrams, and you can solve the all unit tests on the online mode or offline mode, what may be the facility in your college. So in this way, you have to do your study plan. And as I have given some tentative days, that is the for every unit you can get the 15 days for the study. So within a 4 months you can give 15 days for every unit. So in this way, from first unit to means total 8 units, so you can study in the 4 months. So in students, also you have to note that as per the letter dated 3rd September 2020 of Nagpur University, there are some changes done in the syllabus of zoology for the BSc from the semester 1st to the 6th semester. So as per the meeting of the Board of Studies and Academic Council, so these changes are approved. So what type of changes done, that we have to understand here. So for the BSc zoology, the minor changes in BSc zoology semester 1st to 6th and MSc zoology will come to effect from the session 2020-2021 and onwards. It means that some minor changes are done in syllabus of zoology of the BSc. So and these changes are effective from the this session, that is the 2020-2021. Now we have to understand here actually what type of changes are changes done in the syllabus of zoology for the semester first. Now you can see BSc zoology semester first, and this is the revised syllabus of zoology. So already I have explained the original syllabus. Now you have to compare these two syllabuses. Already the link of the original syllabus and revised syllabus I have given in the description of this video. You can see the description of this video by clicking on the more option, and you can get the link. By clicking this link, you can download the PDF file of original syllabus of zoology and revised syllabus of zoology for the semester 1st and 2nd. Now see here, in the paper 1, so this matter is deleted. For example, 2.4 Obelia, structure and life cycle, corals and coral reef formation. And instead of that, there is a substituted, that is the that topic is substituted by, that is Obelia, structure and life cycle, polymorphism in hydrozoa. So in the same way, that 4.3, that matter is deleted and this is added. So you can see here which topic is deleted and which topic is substituted. So as per this table, for the semester first as well as for the semester second also, you can see here what type of changes are done. So simply you can download this PDF file from the given link in the video or description of the video, or also you can search on the website of Nagpur University, and you can compare what type of topic is deleted and in that place what type of topic is added. So you can see here in the fourth paper also some changes done, and in the practical also some changes, especially demonstration of meiosis in Tradescantia bird grasshopper testis by Swash method, that is deleted. Demonstration of salivary gland chromosome in Chironomus larva, that is also deleted. And now what is added? Study of museum specimen by specimens or charts or model, that classification up to the orders. It means that nowadays animal specimens are not available in the laboratories. Instead of, you can use the charts or model of these animals and you can study that particular specimen. So in this way, also dissections, because animals are not allowed for the dissection directly, and so now we can only do the virtual dissection. It means that by the help of the computer softwares or programs, you can see the that particular videos, that is called as a virtual dissections, and then you can study how the dissection can be done. So in this way, what may be the changes done? So that is I have shown here. So simply you have to download these files and compare the what type of changes are done. So dear students, I hope you understood all these things about the syllabus, original syllabus, and what may be the changes taken in the syllabus of zoology for the BSc first year, that is the semester first and second, for the session 2020-2021 to onwards. Dear students, if you like this video, then you can like it. Also, for getting the more information from this channel, you have to subscribe this channel, that is a Techno Scientific Motivator Dr. S.D. Puri, by clicking on the subscribe button. Also, you can press the bell icon for getting the notifications of the new videos. Thank you very much, friends.